Hello and welcome to this latest video from CloudWords.net. My name is Mauricio, and over the next few minutes we'll be talking whether or not you should make your own VPN. We'll get to that in just a second, but before we do, please give a thumbs up if you like this video and don't forget to slap that bell to subscribe to our channel. Now, let's talk VPNs. Okay, so the question before us is if you should make your own VPN. Well, the answer is simply, well, no, you shouldn't. It's a lot of work, and unless you really know what you're doing, the VPN connection you created will likely be insecure, not cover your tracks very well, and won't be able to fool YouTube's filter, let alone that of Netflix or YouTube. That said, if you do know what you're doing and you like to tinker around with all the technical details, go right ahead. It's probably cheaper than taking out a subscription to, say, NordVPN, though you probably won't get the ability to access entertainment sites like Netflix while using it. That's more of an advanced skill, but if all you want is some basic location spoofing plus an extra layer of protection while browsing, then yes, setting up your own VPN is a perfectly good alternative to signing up for one. However, it's going to be a lot more work, and generally speaking, unless you're really into tinkering with tech, signing up for an existing VPN service is probably going to be a lot quicker and a lot less time-consuming. We've already mentioned NordVPN, so let's take this moment to recommend ExpressVPN to you as well. Both are basically great VPNs, though we give Express the edge in our ranking, which I'll paste into the description box below in case you want to check that out. Anyway, let's get back to setting up a VPN. It's a pretty simple process overall, but can get a little tricky in execution as you can run into any of a million issues. As such, I'll just go over the main steps here so you have an idea of what you need to do and you can troubleshoot your own issues as you go. Hey, you're the one doing all DIY here. First up, you need to get a server. Now, there's more than one way to do that. You could repurpose an old computer or Raspberry Pi you're not using, or even buy space via a web hosting company or via AWS. It's up to you. You could even use your own computer as a server using specific software, but that would be a little less safe. Whatever you do, it's best if the server can be online 24/7 so as to guarantee you access. Leave a comment if you want me to cover on how to set up a VPN correctly. With the server set up, all you need to do is get the software to run the VPN. You have two options here. Either you program your own, in which case I wonder why you're watching this video in the first place, or you use some out-of-the-box stuff. Windows and Mac both offer VPN software, but it's not considered very good. So we recommend OpenVPN instead, which is used by many of the VPN services in our ranking as well. Alternatively, you could use the brand spanking new WireGuard protocol as well. The nice thing about OpenVPN and WireGuard both is that you can just open them up and install them without too much fuss, though it's a lot easier if you're on Linux. Still though, there are going to be quite a few issues during setup, and well, you might have to be returning to the manual and to the forums more than once while setting everything up. If all this sounds like a lot of work, that's because it is, and I definitely don't recommend it. Instead, check out the VPN service we like and see which one will fit you best. Though it will cost a few bucks a month, it will save you, in my opinion, a big headache. I hope this helps you make a decision on whether or not to make your own VPN. As I said before, if you would like me to cover the exact steps on how to create a VPN, leave a comment below and I'll happily do this in my next video. Other than that, please subscribe to this channel, give a thumbs up, and hopefully we're gonna see us next time.